there's a couple more.
Hi, everybody. We've come to help. Well, we did knock.
Well, that's all right. Just follow the screams of anguish.
Did you do it all by himself, Mr. Grossack?
I regret to say I'm partly responsible.
But this
all right, all right. We know.
Sorry.
Well, don't just stand there. Do something.
Today. Oh, I'm sorry, my dear. Not a very nice topic of conversation for the breakfast table.
You forget, Colonel, I'm a country girl.
Then we must start cutting lucerne by Monday at the latest.
You'll be busy.
It's that time of the year.
I shall be able to help.
No, no, you've given us enough of your time already, August. You've got the vineyard to think of.
The vineyard needs nothing so much as sunshine now, and that is up to the Lord.
You leave a lot to the Lord, August. I'm sorry.
Your tea, Colonel, I've sugared it. You know I was born in prison. And like Sam, I was taken away when I was one, too. And that was during the war. Well, I was sent to an orphanage. Things were much stricter in those days, and I didn't see my mother until she was released. By then I was six. It was too late for her. She wasn't fit to be a mother. That's what they said. She used to visit me every Sunday. I used to live for those Sundays. What happened to her? Well, one day she just didn't arrive. Found out 2 years later she died. Oh, didn't they tell you? Probably thought it was best I didn't know. Haven't you ever had a home, Mrs. Jackson? Well, by then I was 12. It was a bit late to be adopted. Well, what about your dad? He was killed in the war. What are you doing in here?
I just brought some clean nappies.
Well, hurry up then. Well, let me tell you something about myself that'll add to your sense of superiority. I was born in prison. My mother was a criminal. One of the animals. So if you want to look down at me, Vera, you go right ahead. But it doesn't bother me in the slightest. Because I feel sorry for you. Really sorry.
Good morning, Meg.
Vera.
Have I interrupted anything?
No. Giving you up was the hardest decision I've ever had to make in my life. Hardly a day's gone by since then that I haven't thought about you. I want to show you something. And please, don't think it's corny. I knitted these for you when I was pregnant, and I was never given the chance to give them to you.
Considered having children because my family, the family who raised me, the muscular dystrophy carriers, I thought I was too. And now I don't want kids. When I found out I was adopted, Phil started at me to have a family.
Why don't you?
Look at us.
A nurse, I'll hire one. Righto, then you won't be needing that.
Of course I will. You can do something for me that no one else can.
can be my sister. And that's something I've wanted my whole life.
Is this place open or closed, do you know?
Oh, I guess it's open. They gave me a cup of coffee when I asked for it.
Mm. It's handy to the hospital.
Mm. Look, why don't you knock? I think they're having some trouble in the kitchen. There was a lot of yelling.
Must be an interesting book.
Mm, it is. And I'd really like to continue reading it.
Psychosurgery. Well, well, you must be a nurse.
No, I'm a doctor.
A new intern?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I am. And so are you, right?
I'm Craig Rothwell.
Gail Henderson. Many happy returns.
Oh, Frankie, that was terrific. You must have really worked hard last night.
I'm doing good, eh?
You're doing very well.
Yeah, I'm doing well.
Look, shall I read for a bit and you follow? Bob blows out the candles and makes a wish. He wishes for a pony. Even Jip the dog has some cake. There are lots of good things to eat. There are... No, Frankie. No what? You know what?
Fell in love with the same man.
It doesn't really seem so surprising now, does it?
When that same man tried to kill you, I didn't lift a finger to help. Would your sister have done that?
Well, Jilly, I have tried so hard to forgive you. I think I can now.
You shouldn't. I think I hated you from the moment you married Greg Marsden. Not because I wanted him to, but because once again, Stephanie Harper, poor little rich girl, walked off with the first prize.
And I want to change all that.
Too late.
I don't suppose you got any books on basic writing, have you? For Emma. She doesn't know yet, but I'm going to teach her how to write.
Help yourself.
Anyone in particular?
You choose.
Rodeo trophies?
Uh-huh. How'd she be so good? My whole family were rodeo people. We followed the circuit every year, so... Well, I guess I've had a head start.
Well, you must have seen most of Australia, then.
We did move around a lot.
Well, the best collection I've ever seen. You read them all?
Oh, yes. Yes, of course. Well, I have to check on Jamie, if you'll excuse me. Is there anything else you need to know?
No.
Oh, God.
Where did she say
she was? Quick, hide the dress.
Hi,
the dress? Let me see. It's awful.
Oh.
That's all you're capable of, isn't it? Filth.
Let me out of here for 2 minutes and you'll find what I'm capable of.
You're safe in here for the next 3 days, Doyle.
Yes, well, you won't be safe when I get out. None of yous will.
Any more trouble? We'll keep you in here for weeks.
Oh, so what? Are you going to stand there all day and gloat?
Bet you're dying for a cigarette.
Yeah?
Pity. Against regulations.
Hey, I forgot to tell you. We got a new nickname for you. It's old B's idea. Wanna know what it is? Vinegar tits. Hey, how about that, eh? Vinegar tits.
You really are the most uncouth slut, Doyle.
Oh, don't blame me, Vera. It's old B's idea. She thought it up.
Did she indeed?
Vinegar tits.
When you finish here, you can start on the next floor. That should keep you out of temptation's way. No smart comments, Bryant? Or do you have to have an audience for that? Impressionable young girls, for instance? What could they possibly see in you? But there again, you're not too choosy yourself. Take Sharon Gilmore. But even she didn't seem your type. What do you do, Bryant? Force them into behaving like animals? Or do you just pick out the simple ones? Whichever it is, your sort should be locked away from young girls altogether. You should take a good look at yourself. A lumbering 40-year-old degenerate. And if I so much as hear a complaint against you again, I'll have you up on another charge.
I know all about illness. I've had my problems myself, you know. My organs were all out of place. Well, I can't have no more children, except what I've got, of course. Well, praise the Lord for something. Now, open wide. Come on, we're nearly finished. Just a few more mouthfuls. Here?
Well, what are you first thing in the morning?
I've left my tobacco outside.
I'll get it, Mr. McClure.
Oh, no, Alan.
Well, he's all right. The boy's not hopeless. You see the way he gets under that wagon.
Alan, come over here and sit down. Come on.
No, come here.
Oh, God bless his soul. That's the most beautiful thing I've heard in my life. We would have been married the following autumn at Easter. I always wanted to be an Easter bride. It was going to be his last tour of duty. And we were going to buy that little wooden house that looked out over the bay. The one that was just on the road outside of town. It's all run down now. Some hippie types.
Yes, I know the one.
It was beautiful then. Three bedrooms. Plenty of room for children. He was such a good man. A very good man. The night before he left, he wanted to make love to me. I think he felt something. I think he thought it might be the only time. And I said no. We were well brought up, you see. I didn't think I should, not if I wasn't married. I often wish if I could just have that night back. Just that one night. That's my engagement ring. I keep it in a drawer all year. But on Anzac Day, I take it out and I wear it.
Is everything all right at home, Lorraine? Why do you ask that? Well, you're so different. I imagine we'd have hundreds of things to talk about, but all the way from the prison, you've hardly said a word to me.
Well, look, there is something.
Ron doesn't want me to come and stay with you, does he?
No, Mum, it's not Ron. I don't want you. Oh, look, there's no point in beating about the bush. I've done a lot of thinking these last few years. Ron has done very well at his job, and the children... Well, Judith Ann goes to ballet, and Andrew has his cubs.
What has all this to do with me, Lou?
Everything. I couldn't stand my friends to find out about you. I will not have my family pay for a mistake you made, Mum.
I paid for that mistake, Lorraine.
Yes.
Well, you can't come and stay with us, and that's all there is to it.
I see.
You can call me a bitch if you like. Ron's as good as done that.
Years you let me believe I had a room at your home. Why?
All right. I didn't think I'd ever let you out.
You hoped I'd die there.
Yes. You know, I've never really forgiven you for what you've done. When we moved to the new district, I tried to forget all about you. I want to make a clean break, Mum. Well, at least I'm being honest.
I always wondered what being honest meant.
I'll arrange a room for you somewhere, and Ron will be in touch with you about some financial details.
Could we leave now, please? Open the boot, Lorraine.
What do you want?
Open it.
What are you doing?
I'll catch your bus.
Don't be stupid. I said I'd drive you into town and arrange a room for you.
I'll find my own.
But I can't just drive away and leave you out here.
Why not?
Because you're my mother.
You have no mother, Lorraine. She died in there a few minutes ago. Now just get in your car and drive back to your family.
I hope you enjoyed wasting your time last night.
No, I didn't think it was a waste of time. I quite enjoyed it.
Yes, come to think of it, you'd have an affinity with the working class, with your background.
What do you know about my background?
Oh, enough to know you came from the wrong side of the tracks.
Exactly where you'll end up when I'm finished.
Not a chance.
We'll see. I'm going to make your life such hell, you'll be glad to walk out of here.
If I do, Stephen will come with me.
Stephen will stay where the money is.
He might have it himself by then.
Never. I'm going to keep Stephen and my money, and you can be darn sure I'm going to get rid of you. Quick. My pills. Handbag. Please.
You keep out of it. You know nothing about me, what I think or feel.
Well, the way you talk about him, you must like him a little bit. Anyhow, I reckon you'd smarten him up real quick. You might even get together when you get out of here. I wouldn't mind.
When I get out of here? When I get out of here, I'm going to be 50 years old. Can you see any man waiting that long? Time means nothing to a kid your age. Well, I'll tell you what it means to me. It means I am never going to have any more kids of my own. And I'm never going to have any grandchildren. It means the only thing I've got to look forward to is seeing your father once in a blue moon. Knowing that we can never even be alone together. Never touch. And knowing that we've got no future. Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm tough. I run this place, all right. You know why? Because it gives me something to think about. Because if I think about myself, it scares the living the hell out of me. And why should I be any different to any other woman? I want what they want. A home and a family. I want someone to care about. Oh, and I want someone to care about me. I'm not talking about love. I don't know what that means anymore. Just simple, bloody caring. Well, I've given that up. And that's what I've got to look forward to. Big fat nothing. I am probably going to end up like Lizzie. Nowhere to go, and no one to turn to. Breaking my neck to get back into here. Because it's the only home I know. And the only place I feel safe. And that's what I've got to live with.
Trustee, Mrs. Morris wants to help you.
No one else does.
I do.
You should hate me for what I've done to you.
Seeing as how I was meant to have nicked it, I reckon you won't miss it now.
I need it and I'm keeping it.
Oh, don't hurt her!
I'm not a killer. I didn't kill anyone. I didn't. What are you all doing to me?
Siversen.
Frank, have you ever thought what you might do if you gave up flying?
I can't see it. Besides, what would I do?
You'd always be welcome here. Heaven knows there'd be enough work to keep you busy.
Too much F gas in my veins, Val. I couldn't do a ground job. Flying's my life.
Well, you'd be more than welcome here if you ever did have your feet on the ground. You know that.
You know what you'll think, don't you? That I really want an excuse to see you again. I suppose there could be some truth in that. I do like having you around. You know, Sid always said if anything ever happened to him, I should try and clip your wings. Sid thought that you'd be the only other bloke I could ever be happy with. Funny, isn't it? Oh, I know you'd never really want to settle down. Oh, could have been interesting. Frank, what is it? What's wrong?
I had a pain in my guts. I've had it all day. I think I'm going to pass out. I've got to put this plane down somewhere.
But there's an issue with McCormick's.
I'd never make it anyway. Look for a clearing anyway. What's up there ahead? Isn't that a highway?
But you can't land on that, can you?
No choice. I have to try.
It was hard enough losing Sid. I couldn't bear losing you as well. Oh, thank goodness!
Hello, Joanne.
Sheila. It's been a long time.
Yeah, it has.
Well, I was surprised to get your message.
Not as surprised as I was to get your reply.
Well, I was curious. I mean, we were friends for a long time.
We were. Practically ruled that school.
You got into trouble for it. Do you remember when you glued Mr. Larkin's briefcase shut?
I got the idea when you stole the super grip from the maintenance shed. It's a pity that our friendship fizzled out.
Yes, what a shame. When all you had to do was apologize.
For what?
Oh, look, I've got to run anyway. And good on you for getting back up on stage. Hopefully this time, it won't be so humiliating.
Doreen, you look lovely.
Oh, do you really like it?
Yes.
Yes, you'll be the belle of the secretarial college.
Well, why can't you go on teaching me? I'd like that.
No, I'm sorry, Doreen. I'm going into state tomorrow. I won't be able to teach you anymore.
Mm. What's this?
Sweets for the sweet.
Oh. Oh, gee, thanks, Mrs. Hemmings. This must have cost a packet.
It's a perfume I used when I was about your age. I hope you like it.
Oh, I bet I will. I've never had nothing like this before.
Goodbye, Doreen.
Bye, Mrs. Hemmings. And thanks. It's classy.
I'm sorry to disturb you, but I left my shopping bag in the kitchen. I'll just pop in and get it.
Sure.
Something wrong? Don't you like it? Doreen, what's the matter?
You're my mother. All the time when I was a little kid, and I was trying to remember something about you, all I could ever remember was how good you smelled. Like this.
Doreen, I...
You are, aren't you?
I thought I'd lost you for a minute.
What are you doing here?
Well, I reckoned I'd come with you. Well, I know how to look after myself when I'm on the run, and I don't think you do. You'll be picked up in 2 minutes flat.
Well, look, I'll be all right. You better get back before they miss you.
No, I'm going to help you.
Look, I'm in enough strife as it is. I don't want to drag you into it too.
Oh, I don't care. I'm used to trouble. Besides, you need me. Look at the way you were carrying on just back there.
What do you mean?
Well, walking along and looking around you, that's a dead giveaway. Anybody watching you would know you're trying to get away from something. Look, I know how the cops work, and I can help you get away from them.
Yeah, well, you haven't helped me much so far. I mean, you got me to talk to that friend of yours, and she dobbed me in.
Yeah, well, I don't know why Mrs. Morris did that. But I reckon if it's my fault that the cops are after you, that's all the more reason why I should look after you now. Come on, let's get moving.
Well, where to?
Well, Beverly. I want you to know that Clive and I never planned for this to happen.
Clive and I have had words, but I've got a few for you as well.
I am really, really sorry.
Oh, it's funny how often you get to say that to me.
Yeah, I know. But we should have told you about it when it first happened, but then you had to go off to the conference, and then your niece had that accident, and...
I'm sorry. Are you telling me that you and Clive have been together since before the conference?
Why? What did Clive say?
That he was leaving me to go back to you. Not that you'd been running around behind my back the whole time.
Oh, it wasn't the whole time. I mean, the first time was just, you know, on the desk. And then there was a couple of times after that, and it was in the water hole.
Do you know what you are? You're... Please,
but you'd be in the pan.
Nah, sorry to spoil your day. Doc just fixed me up. Thanks for keeping this warm for me.
Shove off, Moni.
What if I don't?
You gotta wait for some dark night to bash me up like you did Bert?
That's not my style and you know it. You got nothing to worry about as long as you remember I'm back.
Yeah, well, I've been thinking.
That must have been a strain.
Things went pretty well when you weren't here.
Not the way I heard it. Getting rich quick, wasn't it? Making a killing out of Lizzie's first lot of booze. I reckon you ought to split your take with Lizzie.
Yeah, that's what I reckon too.
Oh, shut up, Lizzie.
All right, maybe we ought to let everybody make up their own minds. Okay? Who's it gonna be? I looked after you all right, didn't I?
Looks like they've already decided. Get her out of my road, will you, girls? Doreen, Lizzie.
We don't want any trouble, B.
Looks like you're on your own, Smith.
Doesn't worry me a bit.
Ferguson!
What do you think? It's me outfit for the big day. Gorgeous, isn't it? Valda, you know, from across the road, she recommended the most perfect little local boutique.
That's something.
That's Puce.
Oh, it's Cerise.
Does that make a difference?
Oh, every difference. You see, I chose this colour because the magazine said it complimented my star sign.
Are you kidding? The colour's an insult, not a compliment. It's going to clash with the bridesmaids. It's going to look shocking in the photos. It's going to dominate everything. It doesn't even suit you. You can't wear it.
Now, just a minute. I can put up with your whinging all day long, your tantrums and your hissy fits, but now you are telling me what I can and cannot wear?
Yes, it's hideous.
All right, guys, you just got to breathe.
Shut up, Jared.
All right, you listen to me. You may be able to boss my son around, Missy, but you will not be dictating to me. You can get that straight right now.
Oh, is that right?
That is correct.
How interesting. Well, I wonder whose wedding it is.
It is my son's wedding.
And does that make that yours?
It makes it my wedding.
Well, then why don't you...
Joyce Deirdre Martin, you've been sentenced to 6 months' imprisonment, having been found guilty of accessory after the fact in relation to an armed hold-up and receiving of stolen goods. Is that correct?
That's right, Lynn.
You'll address the officers by name. The title of Miss or Mrs.
Which one are you, love?
Over here, Martin.
So what's your name?
Fletcher.
You know, there's something familiar about you. Where would I know you from?
I'm quite sure we've never met.
Oh, I never forget a face.
This is the life, eh? Not a care in the world.
Sleep well?
Ah, oh, like a log.
Yeah, I didn't. I was awake all night trying to figure out why anyone would want to spend 6 months in here.
You can put up with anything if you got something special waiting for you outside.
Yeah, well, I've got Fred, but I still want to get out of here.
I'm used to not seeing Harry. In 15 years of marriage, he's been 8 inside. Now, I've just discovered more important things in life. I've got to have been in here too long. Harry finally hit the jackpot. Got away with over $150,000. Armored truck job. The trouble is, he had to get away in a kind of hurry, so guess who had to look after the money? I'm the only one who knows where it is. And that little secret I'm keeping right to myself. I got 6 easy months figuring out how I'm going to spend it.
Simon here yet?
Yes, he's in the kitchen uncorking a bottle of champagne. I thought we should celebrate.
How is he?
Oh, fine, fine. You two will get on like a house on fire. Oh, champagne coming up.
Hi, I'm Simon.
I can't find the champagne glasses.
They're in here.
Oh, you two met yet?
Yes, we were just about to introduce ourselves.
Oh, well, allow me. Irene, Simon.
Nice to meet you, Simon.
Yes, Dad's been talking a lot about you.
Don't tell her that. It'll go to her head. I'll be back in a moment.
Well, bit of a shock.
Yes.
How long have you been back?
Oh, a few months. I went to Europe for a while after I left London.
You're not exactly the sort of woman I would have thought Dad would get keen on. But you needn't worry. If you keep your mouth shut, I'll do the same. I don't think either of us want Dad to know what happened in London, do we?
Just thought I'd wait to be asked to come in.
But it's your home.
No, Alf. It's your home. It hasn't worked out, has it?
Don't you want to talk about it?
Oh, I don't think there's anything left to say. I've just come to get my things.
For how long?
For good.
Alf.
No.
There must be something I can do.
I just can't live with somebody who looks at me and sees me as a killer.
That was just
I know. It was just for a second, but it happened, Alf. It wasn't just a spur-of-the-moment thing. You were thinking it.
We can't just call it quits.
I think it's better if we do. See, I'm never going to be able to forgive you for saying it. I'll file for the divorce as soon as possible. Get it all over and done with. Who are you?
I'm an old friend of Jonathan's.
A lie. My father wouldn't let you on the place.
No need to be frightened, girlie.
Look, we don't want to quarrel. I know what it's like. There's been times when I've been too tired to be rational. Why don't you just drink your drink and give us a big smile, eh?
I want out, Jeff.
Well, that's a bit of a change of pace, isn't it?
I had time to think.
Has Leela had anything to do with your thinking?
No, it's got nothing to do with Leela. I've just got over one emotional disaster. I'm not prepared to try again.
Oh, crap.
I can't take that risk.
Leela's really been getting to you, hasn't she?
I can make my own decisions.
And you've decided not to see me again. And you made the decision all on your own, right?
Yes.
Good. I just wanted to get things straight, that's all.
So will you please go now?
No. No, I don't think I will. Sit down.
Now it's your turn to get something straight. Nobody, but nobody gives me the boot.
Do you understand, girl?
Oh, just shopping. What the hell's the matter with you?
I told you I couldn't. I told you I couldn't.
Look, it's all right, Marg. Don't upset yourself anymore. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
Mrs. Skilton, won't you let me give you at least a mild sedative just to help settle you down?
I can't take any drugs.
Maybe doctor knows best, love.
I don't want anything. Thank you for bringing me home. Now, I'd just like to be left alone.
Mrs. Skilton, I'd like to talk to you. I'd like to try and help.
Well, won't you talk to the doctor, love? Surely just talk can't do any harm.
I think we'll be right now. Thanks, Frank.
Right, doctor. Mrs. Skilton. Oh, Mr. Skilton, your car's in the supermarket car park.
Thanks, Serge.
No troubles.
You disappoint me, Wilkinson.
Don't you come near me or I swear I'll...
You'll what? Tell your friends you lagged on them? I don't appreciate people giving me a hard time, Wilkinson, and that's just what you've done.
I told you about the sabotage. I lagged on the only real friends that I've got.
You didn't tell me about the alarm. That very important alarm.
Don't you come any closer!
Cheap little slag like you making things difficult for me.
You could have killed Rita.
Oh, don't worry. I'll kill her. Things will settle down here. But that's the least of your worries. I told you what had happened to your kid.
You burn in hell before you lay one
hand on
my... That's
a common cry around here, Wilkinson. Your daughter doesn't have to suffer just yet, but you do, just a little. Everybody seems to think that I tried to use this to kill Connors, but you're going to tell them that you did. You'll think of a reason. Otherwise, your little girl is his...
Ah!
Small bell's all right.
I know.
Yeah, looks healthy enough. Blood supply's good.
Could you check the patient's blood pressure?
Oh, it's fine. It's fine. You better check peristaltic movements.
Look, I know already. Will you stop telling me? I know what to do. I'm the one doing the operation, okay?
I'm sorry.
Don't you two blokes walk out on me now. I could have a bit of trouble getting home in my condition.
There's nothing for you to worry about, Mr. Bennett. No one will be leaving here until they're finished, I can assure you. Doctors are only joking.
Yeah. Never knew operations were like this. I always thought they were serious.
Look, as for you two getting more serious, I'm prepared to talk about that in time.
Yeah, well, that's why we're here, mate.
Eh? Bruce pregnant.
I'm going to have Frank's baby.
Yeah, the kids have made a mistake, but they're willing to face up to it and make a go of things. I reckon that's a pretty courageous decision. After everything I told you about, after everything I warned you about, you go and get... It's got to be some sort of joke.
There's no point blaming anyone. It's a fact of life.
Yeah, is that all right?
I want to have it. We both do.
But you just kid yourselves. What about adoption? Have you thought about that?
No, we want to keep it.
Ah, they're set on it, mate. Yeah, well, perhaps we ought to talk about this a bit more later on, mate. Yeah. Leave it, eh, Ruthie? We'll talk later.
Well, the inspector has asked us to look after him tonight. If she hasn't turned up in the morning, well, I'm just going to have to lay it on the line for him. Tell him that something might have happened to her and he's going to have to help us find her.
Oh, dear. Let's hope she comes.
Yeah, look, but Marge, if you do hear anything, it doesn't matter what time it is, just give us a call, okay? Okay, Marge, bye.
I found this in Danny's pocket.
No, what is it, love?
It's a phone number.
Huh?
Think you ought to try it?
That's the only lead we've got. May as well. 9427. Oh, hello, look, I was wondering if it...
What was that all about?
Oh, it's one of those recorder things where you've got to leave your message after the beep.
Well, why didn't you leave your message?
Well, those damn things intimidate me. I can never think what to say quick enough.
Oh, Russ. Well, think of what you're going to say and ring them back.
Mm-hmm.
Who was it, anyway?
Miss Mason's office, I think, yeah.
It's odd.
What's that?
Regardless of the outcome of Nolan's case, she was supposed to be transferred to Barnhurst. And all you can tell me is you couldn't find her. Just how are you running, Wentworth, Erica?
To the best of my ability, Ted.
Look, I tried to hold up the investigation on the work release scheme for as long as possible. But after what's been happening here... Well, there's the implication of Ewan Reynolds, Meg Jackson's association with an inmate's father, and now an officer involved with Nolan.
Well, you've read my reports.
I'm sorry, but the department isn't happy. They're sending over an inspector, Stuart Gillespie. He'll be spending some time here, and no doubt he'll be suggesting quite a few changes. If Wentworth isn't run the way he feels it should be, I don't have to warn you of the consequences.
I've been so ashamed in all my life.
She hit me first.
Willie, really, Madge, this is the sort of thing I would expect from a 5-year-old.
Well, she did. You frown all your life, I don't care. Well, come on, I'm late.
Stop fighting in the street. I mean, where is your dignity?
Are you going to help me or not?
Well, you must admit it was not very ladylike.
Who says I'm a lady?
Doll.
Where are you going?
I'm going to see if Mrs. Mangle is all right, of course.
Whose side are you on, for heaven's sake?
Nobody's, actually.
Harold, if you set one foot outside that door, that's it.
Bully.
She has got you wrapped around her little finger.
I worry about her.
Well, why don't you worry about me for a change?
With a punch like yours, I'd be doing better to worry about myself.
Harold!
Door. Who's got who wrapped around whose little finger?
I'm getting out of here and I reckon I'm well on the way to being cleared.
What, for real?
How did you manage that? Ryan's being investigated by a special cop branch. The guy heading it up's a real decent sort of bloke.
A decent cop? That's got to be a new species.
I'm as good as bailed out, just as soon as Mrs. Powell puts in the application.
Caused enough disruption. Get back to work. She's just jealous of my voluptuous body.
I believe this. You've beaten the system and actually got the cops working for you.
Yes, but only because of that first article you wrote about me.
All right, just check all of that and then sign for it.
I trust you, Mrs. Powell. I'm sure you haven't pinched a thing.
No back chat. Just sign.
Don't you forget that if you ever want a job, you come up and see me. I'll put you in the bargain basement.
There's no point talking to someone who lies and deceives.
Lies? About what? Come on, tell us.
Tell them about your other girlfriend, Lewis.
See, I told you, you owe me.
Cheryl, will you listen to me, please?
Do you know, people have been trying to tell me for weeks, but no, I wouldn't have it. I knew you better than I did. I actually defended you. Can you believe it?
She is not my girlfriend. You've got it all wrong.
Oh, give it up. I saw the two of you together. Was she worth the $2,000?
What?
The money that came from our account. I saw you give her a gift. I saw her kissing you. Are you still going to lie your way out of this?
No, but are you going to let me explain?
Ah, now when you're caught out, you care to explain. Well, I know the explanation. The explanation is clear, and if I hadn't had so much faith in you, I would have seen it long ago.
Cheryl, sit down and listen.
No, I've seen enough, Lewis, and heard enough, and I heard an awful lot, and I don't want to hear anymore.
You accuse me of having an affair. I have every right to defend myself.
I saw you. I saw how she looks at you.
I thought you knew me better than that. The girl you saw...
Please give me credit. Don't make it any worse.
The girl you saw is my daughter.
Good morning, Nurse Adams.
Don't you ever sleep, sister?
I wouldn't, if all my nurses lived it up the way you do.
Have you any complaints about my work?
No, nurse, only your morals. I think you should examine your conscience. Nursing requires a certain amount of dedication. And if you're not prepared to give it, I suggest you concentrate on whatever else it is you do best.
Sister Scott, the only thing that would make me give up nursing at the moment is the thought of turning into a vinegary old maid.
Miss Saunders.
Carmel.
Carmel. Please don't think I'm not grateful for all the work you're putting into my case.
What?
Well, today's David's preliminary hearing. And I wish you'd just concentrate on that. How's it going?
Oh, as well as can be expected, I'm afraid.
And how's he? He's not taking it too hard, is he?
Oh, he's bearing up. He seems resigned. Now, Fat, I'm sorry, but we really must talk about your appeal.
My appeal? My appeal won't be worth tuppence once Herbie makes his statement in there.
Now, what possible damage could his statement do you?
Well, what if he said that I saw David before that gunfight?
What are you talking about? I've got a copy of his statement. There's no mention of a prior meeting in here. Don't worry, Pat. We're going to come through this with flying colours.
Well, I'd like to start as soon as possible.
Yeah, I'll clear it with Mrs. Davidson as soon as she gets back. Oh, Carmel, sorry to keep you waiting.
Well, well, Miss Saunders. Still champion of the underdog.
Yes, you too, I understand. How are you, Mr. Pierce?
Very well, thanks.
Mr. Fletcher's just gone to get Pat.
Fine, fine.
I'll see you soon, Paul.
Yeah.
You too, probably.
No doubt. Bye.
All right, let's go and see if we can convince Pat O'Connell.
I'd like to throw her out, but of course, if you'd like to talk...
Of course I don't.
Things would be a lot easier if you weren't hovering.
Oh, excuse me. You barged your way into my home. I'm staying put.
If we're going to have a domestic, I think we ought to have it at home.
Is that what you think this is? A domestic tiff? We're splitting up, Patricia. I'm not going to change my mind, so you may as well leave.
But it's all come out of nowhere.
It's been building up for months.
I was only trying to help you.
Well, I don't want your help anymore. Now, go home. You're just making a fool of yourself.
All right. You're so weak, I'm probably better off without you. Oh, don't look so smug. Has he told you who Andrew's mother is yet?
Patricia.
It's obviously a big mystery. I don't know what it is. Her name's Helen Green. Ring any bells? Ah, I can see that it does. Oh. Explain your way out of that one, darling.
I can explain, Bobby.
Well, it had better be damned good. For the life that you want.
So she'll be happy.
What can you offer her? Hmm? The town spinster who lives by proxy. You live through everybody else because you've got no life of your own. I mean, I can offer her the world, Celia. I can introduce her to influential people.
She is not your daughter.
She is not yours either.
But she is Alfred's, and she's going to need
Alfred
her family.
Alfred is married...
to a very decent woman.
To an ex-con who murdered her father.
He was a terrible man.
Oh, now, don't tell me you condone murder, too.
Of course not, but there are certain facts which change the way...
The fact is that Alfred threw Ruth out. The fact is that he is married to a woman I do not want influencing Ruth, and the fact is that you are a desperately lonely woman who will not accept that your niece wants to live with me and not with you.
You are impossible.
Thanks for dropping by, Celia. I do so enjoy our little battle. Sorry. Talks. Next time you want to get in touch, though, please don't. There's a good girl.
You're nothing but a big bag of wind. No one's going to help you. You want to know why? Because Sharon and Mia got it all sewn up, see? And if you ever do get out of here, we're going to be waiting for you. We'll probably start by giving you a short back and sides. Or maybe the silent treatment till you really crack. Oh, but it's the nights that are going to get to you the worst. Lying there all alone, too scared to open your eyes, wondering where you're going to cop it.
The time's pressing.
You can't leave us here like this, please. Let Andrew go, please.
Oh, now she remembers she's a mother. Sorry, Connie. You could try yelling, but it won't do you much good. This whole area is scheduled for redevelopment. Most of the houses are all like this, empty, waiting to be leveled. So, you can scream all you like, darling. No one's gonna hear.
He's leaving.
I don't believe it. Thank heavens you're here. Oh, Connie, the bar is yours.
Oh, Mrs. Hackett, I can't work. Look. I've got a doctor's certificate. This is Cuddles. This is the man that saved my life.
Cuddles?
I expect you to have finished all that by the time I get back, Leslie. I don't want you rattling and banging around the house while we're at luncheon.
Yes, Miss Falconer.
You've got just 4.5 minutes to get those figures sorted out. Don't touch that, son. That's another thing. Watch the children on Saturdays.
Mr. King, why 4.5 minutes?
Because Miss Falconer will be here at 11 o'clock on the dot. Hurry!
Pick it up, Grandma. You're closer.
Over there.
See you at the other end.
Right.
Mr. Perkins?
Mrs. Perkins, it's no use. Don't run, Mrs.
Save your breath.
You do understand, love. I have to. Hello. This is Elizabeth Birdsworth. I've made up me mind. Yeah. Come over and I'll tell you.
Different than